Hello everyone, I'm Harshal Bombardi, a final year engineering student from IIT Bombay class 2017. Today we are going to learn about arithmetic progression, which is a part of sequence and series. So first of all, let's see what is a sequence. Okay, so sequence is an order list of numbers which follow a certain criteria to follow. Okay, so if I write 2, 3, 5, 8, 13. So this particular sequence is known as Fibonacci sequence. Okay. Here T n plus 2 is equals to T n plus 1 plus T n. Okay. So the number is equals to the sum of two preceding numbers. Okay. So if we can write a sequence in this form. Okay, let's say T of n represents the nth term, and if we can write the nth term in some form of arithmetic expression, then that sequence is known as arithmetic progression. Okay, so generally in arithmetic progression we have the nth term, the first term and the common difference. Okay, and we can write nth term is equal to first term plus n minus 1 multiplied by the common difference. Okay, so this formula is known as the nth term formula. Okay, we can write the arithmetic progression as a1 comma a2 comma a3 comma dash 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 and so on. Okay, here we can define a3 as T3 is equal to A1 plus T minus 1 D. Okay, here we will get A1 plus 2D. And we can define A11 as T11 equals to A1 plus 11 minus 1 D. We will get A1 plus 10 D. Okay, so this is a simple procedure we have to follow. And we can have D as positive or negative. Okay, so if D is positive, our arithmetic progression will be increasing, and if we have negative, our arithmetic progression will be decreasing. Okay, it is a fun activity. You can plot the sequence on a graph paper. Okay, x-axis and y-axis, just plot the sequence as here n. Take x as n and take y axis as tn. Okay, you should try it. You should be getting a straight line. Okay, so next thing is sum of ab. Okay, here I have a1 up to an and I want to sum all the terms. Okay, so what I can do is I can write Sn is equal to a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus dot 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 plus an. Okay, but it is a tedious process. I can't do this. Okay, so we will do some tricks and derive a formula. Okay, so using the associative property of addition, I can write it as backwards. Okay, so an plus an minus 1 plus an minus 2 plus dot 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 plus a1. Okay, now I will sum these two equations, then I will get 2sn is equals to, let's sum this, I will get a1 plus an, or I can write a1 plus a1 plus n minus 1d, and this will give me 2a1 plus n minus 1d. Okay, now summing these two, I will get a2 plus an minus 1d, n minus 1. Okay, and a2, I can write a2 as a1 plus d and an minus 1 as plus a1 plus n minus 2d. And summing these terms, I will get 2a1 plus n minus 1b. Okay? If I do all these terms like this, pairwise, I will get this term. Okay? And I am summing it n times. So I can write 2sn is equal to n times 2a1 plus n minus 1b. And this 2 I will put here, then I will get Sn is equal to n by 2, 2a1 plus n minus 1d. Okay, so this is a standard formula for the sum of ab, and we can let's see what I do with this. A1 plus a1 plus n minus 1d. Okay. Now, we remember that this is the formula for Ts. So, I can write n by 2 a1 plus an. Okay. So, this formula is for first term and last term. Okay. Now, if we want to know the nth term with the help of sum of n terms and sum of n minus 1 terms. So, we can write Tn is equal to Sn minus Sn minus 1. Okay. Let's say I have 5 terms. Okay. A1, A2, A3, A4 and A5. Then Sn. What will Sn will be? S5. Okay. S5 means sum of all these numbers. And Sn minus 1 will be S4. Okay. Sum of these numbers, and if I subtract sum of these numbers S4 from S5, I will get A5. Hello. Okay. Now, you will face some question in which you will be given properties like sum of 3 terms of AP or sum of 4 terms in AP. Okay, so I will categorize as odd term and even term. Okay, in this type of questions you will get odd numbers of terms. Okay, so like 3 terms or 5 terms. Okay, and you will be given some properties of them like sum of 5 terms or sometimes. And here you will be getting sum of 4 terms or 6 terms, okay, and so on. Here you can write, let's say you have x, y and z. Okay, so you will write it as a minus b, a and a plus b. Okay, this is a standard form to write, and whenever you are getting 4 or 6 like even terms, then you can write p q r s as a minus 2d, a minus d, a plus d and a plus 2d. Okay, if you write in this form, the question will be easier to solve. Okay, thank you.